This video is in continuation with the next topic of the unit 3rd, which is data link layer. So today's topic we are going to discuss over various protocol, and the first protocol is the stop and wait. So what are the various rules in the stop and wait protocol? First, the sender side sends one data packet at a time. Second rule, next packet only after receiving the acknowledgement of the previous. At the receiver end, send acknowledgement after receiving and consuming of the data packet. Second rule is, after consuming, packet acknowledgement need to be sent. So here we have the diagram like how data is being sent. Once the data is sent, acknowledgement is received, data sent, acknowledgement received. Only after the acknowledgement is received, data will be sent. How, let's understand it's working, how it works. Sender A send a data frame or packet with sequence number 0. Receiver B, after receiving data frames, send an acknowledgement with sequence number 1. Sequence number of the next accepted data frame or the packets, right? There's only one with sequence number, with that implies both sender and receiver have buffer for one frame or packet only. So let's understand with the diagram. Here we have A and B. Send the frame 0 and receive the acknowledgement 1, then send the frame 2 and then send the acknowledgement of the 0. Suppose in the next step the frame 0 was discarded. So after a certain time out, what it will do, it will retransmit the frame, then the acknowledgement is received. Similarly, if the acknowledgement is not received, then only after the timeout the frame will be resent. So here we can easily understand with the help of the diagram how stop and wait work. It waits for some time. If acknowledgement is not received within time, it retransmit that particular frame. Next protocol is go back and ARQ. It's a special case of general sliding window protocol where the transmitter or sender window size is n and the receiver's window size is 1, which means that it can transmit n frames to the receiving node before waiting for the feedback. Now the receiver's duty is to keep track of the sequence number of the next frame it expected to receive and send the feedback after every data packet it receives. Once the sender has sent all the frames in its window, it makes sure that it has then received all feedbacks of the transmitted data frames. If in any case it hasn't received any feedback of the data packet and the time and the out timer expires, it then resend all the data packets again, starting from the lost data packet to the final data packets. So here we'll understand with the help of the diagram, like the sender sent some packets P1, P2, P3 and 4. Suppose the P2 was lost. So what will happen after receiving an acknowledgement of P1, it will retransmit all the frames. So in the next step, you can easily see all the frames after P2 have been retransmitted, P2, P3, P4 and so on. So as the name indicates, go back n, that means we need to go n steps back after the last acknowledgement received. We have to send all the frames back. Next protocol is the selective repeats. This is the another protocol. You can clearly understand by the name here, only the few selected frames or packets are resended. Selective repeat protocol provide for sending multiple frames depending upon the availability of frames in the sending window, even if it does not receive acknowledgement for any frame in the interim. The maximum number of frames that can be sent depend upon the size of the sending window. The receiver records the sequence number of the earliest incorrect or unreceived frame. It then fills the receiving window, then the subsequent frames that it has received. It sends the sequence number of missing frame along with every acknowledgement frame. The sender continues to send the frame that are in its sending window. Once it has sent all the frames in the window, it retransmit the frame whose sequence number is given by the acknowledgement. It then continues sending the other frames. Here we can clearly understand with the help of the diagram, like here these are the sender's frame and these are the receiver frame. So what, once the sender starts sending its frame 1 and 2 and after receiving the acknowledgement, that means it has received the acknowledgement for all the 2 frames. If the frame 3 is lost and frame 4 was sent next, that means the 2 frames have not been received, then it will retransmit only the frame which was not received. So as the name indicates, selective repeat, so it will send only the selected frames. Next is the sliding window protocol. The sliding window protocol are the data link layer protocol for reliable and sequential delivery of the data frames. The sliding window is also used in transmission control protocol. In these protocols, the sender has a buffer called the sending window and receiver has a buffer called the receiver window. The size of the sending window determines the sequence number of the outbound frames. If the sequence number of the frame is an n-bit field, then the range of sequence number that can be assigned is 0 to 2 power n minus 1. Consequently, the size of the sending window is 2 power n minus 1. Thus, in order to accommodate a sending window size of 2 power n minus 1, a n-bit sequence number is chosen. The sequence number are numbered as modulo n. For example, if the sending window size is 4, then the sequence number will be 0, 1, 2, 3. Then again, it will repeat from 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, and so on. The number of bits in the sequence number is 2 to generate the binary sequence 0001101. The size of the receiving window is the maximum number of the frames that the receiver can accept at a time. It determines the maximum number of frames that the sender can send before receiving the acknowledgement. So here we can understand with the help of the, this is the sending window and the receiving window, which is priorly fixed before sending the data. So here we have size 4, here also we have size 4. So frame 0 and 1 has been sent, then the window will shift to the next pointer, right? Similarly, it will shift once the frame has been acknowledgement to the next point. So this was all about the sliding window. In the next video, we'll continue with the next topic. Thank you.